Sinbad the Sailor. Long time ago, in the city of Baghdad, lived a man named Sinbad the Porter. He was very poor. He made his living by carrying goods on his head. He was poor, but a hard-working man. One hot summer day, as he was carrying goods, he got very tired, so he decided to rest for a while. He sat on a bench in front of a wealthy merchant's house. As he rested, he felt a pleasant breeze and heard soothing music and light voices full of laughter. He stood up and pushed the gates open slightly. As he peeked through them, he saw a garden full of flowers. As he went further ahead, he saw servants carrying all sorts of rich and delicious meals. There were a few rich-looking people sitting around the dining table. He said to himself, "Each morning I wake up in pain. Every day I have to carry heavy load on my head to make a living. But others, they live in comfort and delight with pretty songs, good food and laughter." He came back and slept on the bench. After resting for a while, Sinbad the Porter decided to carry on with his work. He picked up his heavy crate and started to walk. Just then, a servant boy came walking towards him. He said, "Please come inside. My master wishes to meet you." They walked through the gardens and entered a majestic house. They went to the grand dining room. The sound of music and laughter filled in the air. Rich people were enjoying their food. The master of the house asked him to take a seat. He ordered his servant to give him food. The porter happily ate the food. He thanked the master for inviting him and offering food. The master replied, "You are most welcome and may your day be blessed. Tell me, what is your name and what do you do for a living?" "My name is Sinbad the Porter. I carry goods on my head for hire to earn a living." The master of the house smiled and said, "You should know that you and I have something in common." "What is it, master?" "Our name. I am Sinbad the Sailor." He further said, "You look very sad. Please tell me, what is bothering you?" The porter replied, "Poverty and hardship has made me sad. Each morning, I wake up in pain. Every day, I have to carry heavy load on my head to make a living. I work so hard, but still, I don't earn enough to live happily. While others like you live in comfort and delight with pretty songs, good food, and laughter." The master patted on his back affectionately and said, "Even I was poor once. But you should know that I have worked very hard to achieve all of this. I became wealthy only by hard work, fate, and destiny. I made 7 voyages at sea, and each of them is an adventure in itself. If you have time, I shall tell you about each one of my adventures. That way, you can understand how hard I have worked in my early years." The porter said, "Sure, Majesty, I would love to hear about your adventures." Sinbad the Sailor started narrating his first adventure. "After my father left, I spent all his wealth and was left with nothing. But I decided to work hard and earn all the wealth back. I decided to become a merchant. One day, I started a journey on a ship along with a few other traders. It was a smooth sail. The cool breeze, the smooth waves, I was enjoying my journey. We passed many islands on our way. After traveling for many days, we reached near an amusing island. The captain said, "Hey, look, an island." Everyone was surprised to see the island. The island was actually a big resting whale on which trees had grown. The captain said, "We all should stop on this island and take some rest." We reached near the island and anchored our ship. All of us went on the island. We were hungry, so some of us started preparing food. And some decided to take rest. I decided to take a look around the island. So I started walking. Everything around was strange but beautiful. I walked for a long time and reached deep into the forest. There were a variety of insects flying around. "This is all wonderful, but I think something is wrong. The land feels a bit different." Suddenly, everything around me started shaking. "Oh my God, what is happening? Why is the land moving? I have to get back to the ship." I started running towards the ship. But I had come far away from the ship, deep inside the forest. The others who were preparing food also started shaking and moving. Captain said, "Why is the island moving? Something is wrong. Oh my God, this is not an island. It is a sleeping whale. We woke her up because of the fire. Let's get back to the ship." All of them ran and got inside the ship. They were so afraid that they did not bother to check if everyone had come back to the ship. They started the ship and tried to move away as quickly as they could. When they were a little away, they realized that it was not an island. It was actually a whale. The whale had been sleeping for a long time. So an entire forest had grown over it. The whale got up due to the fire we had started. It wanted to destroy the fire and so decided to get deep inside the water. I was running as fast as I could to catch the ship. But suddenly, the land started shaking heavily and I fell down. The whale started going under the water. It was taking down the entire forest along with it. I shouted to my friends, but it was of no use. They could not hear me as the ship had gone far away. I thought I was going to drown and die, but I decided to swim and save my life. I said to myself, I must not lose hope. I took help of a wooden log and decided to keep floating. I floated for several days. I was so tired that I fell asleep. When I woke up, I realized that I had reached a shore. I was hungry and thirsty. I decided to explore the shore and get some help. Suddenly, I saw a soldier riding on a royal horse. He was coming towards me. He stopped near me and said, "Who are you? I have never seen you here." "I am not a thief. I am a sailor. I got lost and reached your island. I need your help." He gave me some food and water. He told me that he comes to the shore only a few times in a year to feed the king's horses. "You are lucky that you met me. Come with me. I will take you to our king." I sat on another horse and he took me along with him. He walked through the small and beautiful kingdom and reached the king's palace. I narrated my entire story to the king. The king said, "The sea is full of surprises. You never know what will you come across. But don't worry, you are a brave man. I will ask my people to take good care of you. Oh Majesty, I am happy for your help, but I would be very grateful if you can give me some work to keep me engaged." The king said, "You can work on our port." I started living on the island. I kept accounts of the ships and goods coming and going from the port. I worked very hard every day. But I always used to wonder, how will I ever get back to Baghdad? Months passed. One day, the ship that had abandoned me came to the port. I immediately recognized the ship and the captain. "Oh, Captain, it's me, Sinbad." "Oh, yes, Sinbad, you are alive. I am so sorry. We abandoned you." "No problem, Captain. Will you please take me back to Baghdad?" "Sure, Sinbad." I went to the king and told him everything. As the king was very happy with my work and behavior, he decided to let me go. He gave me a lot of gold coins as a reward. I said goodbye to everyone and boarded the ship. We traveled for days to get back to Baghdad. I was happy to reach Baghdad and meet my family. This was the story of my first voyage. Did you enjoy it?
Yes, Master.
Are you ready for the second voyage?
Yes, Master.
Sinbad the sailor started narrating the second voyage. After my first voyage, I built a big and beautiful house in Baghdad. My wife gave birth to a beautiful daughter. I was living happily with my family. I resumed my business as a merchant. But after a few days, I thought of getting back on the ship to explore the world. I said goodbye to my family and set off on another voyage. I was enjoying the calm breeze and the cool waves. We traveled for many days. After a few days, we reached near an island. We decided to stop on that island. We went towards it and anchored our ship. It was a beautiful island. All of us got down and I started exploring the island. I must make sure that this time I don't go deeper in the island. I don't want to be left behind just like the last time. After walking for a long, long time through the beautiful island, I decided to take some rest. So I slept for some time. When I woke up after some time, I decided to join my friends back on the ship. So I walked towards the ship. "What? What is this? Where is the ship?" "No, they left me behind. Oh no, not again. What should I do now? I must find out a way to escape from the island." I decided to find help, so I walked around for some time. But there was no one around. I'm sure some ships will pass by the island. I should take their help. I climbed a tree to get a better view of the sea. I reached to the top of the tree and started looking for a passing ship. Hours passed, but nobody came along. "What is that? It looks like a giant white rock." I came down the tree and went near it. "Oh, what is this? It looks strange. This rock is so smooth and soft." Suddenly, a big shadow fell on me. When I looked up, I saw a giant bird right above my head. "Oh God,
save me from that bird. The giant bird came flying down very fast. I quickly hid behind the rock. The bird came down and sat near the big white rock, which was actually that giant bird's egg kept in a nest. I wish I could ask the giant bird to take me back to Baghdad. I think I have an idea. I took my belt and tied myself to the bird's leg, and off the bird flew. The bird was flying very high. I was very afraid. After flying for a long time, the bird flew down and landed near a few rocks. I untied myself and started running. And suddenly, I fell down. I was going down and down and down. And finally, I landed in a deep valley. Oh, where am I? It is so dark. It must be deep under the ground. I started looking around. Suddenly, I saw a giant snake coming towards me. It came and stopped right in front of me. The snake tried to attack me, but somehow I managed to escape. When I saw carefully, there were many giant snakes around. So many snakes. But what are all these snakes doing here? Suddenly, I saw a lot of rubies and diamonds lying around on the ground. They were shining brightly. Wow! Rubies! Diamonds! If I can take some of them along with me, I will become very rich. And now I understand what are the snakes doing here. They are protecting the stones. I started looking around to find a way to escape from the valley. I can smell something. What is this smell? When I walked further, I saw a big piece of meat lying on the ground next to a big rock. I went near it. Yes, this is meat. I can smell it. There were a few rubies and diamonds stuck to the meat. Suddenly, the giant bird came down flying. I hid myself behind the rock. The bird landed in the valley. What is this bird doing here? I think it must have come to take the meat. I thought of an idea. I gathered as many rubies and diamonds I could and kept them in my pockets. I moved the rock so that the giant bird could easily see the piece of meat. This time, I tied myself to the piece of meat. Yes, my idea worked. I am out of the pit. I am flying again. After some time, the giant bird dropped the piece of meat. As I was tied to the piece of meat, we went flying down and fell in a giant bird's nest next to the giant eggs. When I looked around, I saw a few merchants standing there. They quickly came near me and took me out of the nest. They also took out the piece of meat and started removing the stones which were stuck to it. Hello, mister. Who are you? I am Sinbad, the sailor. And who are you? One of them said, "We are merchants. We often come here to take the rubies and diamonds. We throw large chunks of meat on the diamonds in the valley to lure the giant bird. The stones get stuck to the meat. When the giant bird carries the meat out of the valley, it also carries along the stones stuck to it. When he drops the meat in the nest, we take those stones." "But what are you doing here?" "My friends abandoned me. I am stuck here on this island. Can you take me along with you?" "Sure." We boarded their ship and set off. We traveled for many days. Those merchants dropped me off at Baghdad. I showed the rubies and diamonds to my wife. "Wow, they are beautiful." "Yes, they are beautiful and precious. We are wealthy now." This was the story of my second adventure. I hope you enjoyed it.
"Yes, Master, I enjoyed it very much. Please tell me about your next adventure."
"Sure." Sinbad started narrating his third voyage.
After my previous voyage, I became rich. I was living happily with my wife and daughter. I started helping the people of my town. I used to distribute food and clothes to the poor. I became famous in my town and people started respecting me. I decided to go on another journey with my friends and other merchants. I said goodbye to my family and we started our journey. We traveled for many days. I was enjoying my time on the ship. We traveled past many islands. One day, there was a storm. The wind was blowing fiercely. Big waves were hitting our ship. There was thunder, lightning, and heavy rain. All the things on the ship, including us, were moving here and there on the ship. Myself and my three other friends fell in the sea. "Help us! Help us, Captain! Help us! I am not able to stop the ship. Wait, I will throw a boat for you." The captain threw a boat for us. Somehow, we managed to get into the small boat. We saw our ship sailing away from us. One of my friends said, "We are going to die. We cannot survive on this boat." Don't lose faith. Somehow, we have to save our lives. We will row this boat and search for an island. We started rowing our boat. We traveled for many days. Finally, we saw an island. "Look, an island! We must go to that island and save our lives." We rowed our boat towards that island. All of us were hungry, so we started searching for food. We saw a big castle. We decided to go inside that castle. As we walked inside, we saw a lot of scary things. There were bones and skeletons lying all around. Strange animals were hiding and watching us. Suddenly, the land started shaking. There were big thuds on the ground as if someone was walking. A big giant monster was walking towards us. He was huge and dangerous. He stood right in front of us and said, "I am hungry. I am going to eat you." We started running to save our lives. But the monster caught one of my friends. We have to save our friend. But how? He is so big and dangerous. I have an idea. I took a bamboo that was lying around and tied a cloth to it. Then I took two stones and rubbed them on each other several times to create fire. I set the cloth on fire. Then I threw the bamboo aiming for the monster's eye. "Oh no, my eye! I can't see!" He took this opportunity and started running. Strange animals were chasing us. But somehow, we managed to escape. We got in our boat and started rowing as fast as we could. Soon, we were far away from that island. We were rowing our boat in the hope of saving our lives. We traveled for many days. And finally, I saw another island. "Look, an island!" We rowed our boat towards that island. It was beautiful. There were a lot of fruits on the trees. We thought we were safe on that island. Suddenly, I saw a giant snake coming towards us. We started running to save our lives. As we looked back, there were many snakes chasing us.
Sinbad, do something. We are going to die.
I thought of an idea. We gathered a few tree branches and decided to build a shelter. All of us got inside it. The snakes were coming from all the directions. The snakes started attacking us. But they did not realize that there were sharp thorns on the branches. When they attacked us, they got wounded by the sharp thorns and died. We had finally saved our lives. We saw our ship at a far distance. We got into our small boat and sailed towards our ship. The captain helped us to get back in our ship. We traveled back for many days and reached Baghdad. I reached home and narrated the whole story to my wife.
Oh, thank God you are safe.
Yes, my dear, I am very lucky to be back with my family. So this was the story of my third voyage. Scary, isn't it?
Yes, Master. It was very scary.
Please tell me about the next voyage.
Yes, sure.
Sinbad started narrating the next voyage.
I was lucky to be alive after my third voyage. My wife requested me to stop sailing the sea. You have a family. You cannot put your life in danger. But me, being a sailor, could not stop myself from going on the next voyage.
Don't worry, dear. I will be fine. I said goodbye to my family and left for the next voyage along with a few other merchants. We traveled for many days. I was enjoying my journey. One day, a storm made the sea wild and fearsome. Thunder, lightning, strong winds, and heavy rain made it difficult to sail. All the men and goods were thrown in the sea. We took support of drums, wooden planks, and whatever we could to save our lives. We were floating for many days. After a few days, we reached near an island.
Look, an island! We should try and get to that island.
All of us put in all our efforts and reached the island. It looked like a wooden island. There were huge trees all around. We decided to explore. After walking for a long time, we reached near a firehouse. We saw tribal people dancing around the fire. We should ask those people for help. They are tribals. They do not like visitors. I don't think it is a good idea to approach them. Do you have any other plan? Finally, we decided to approach those people. The tribals welcomed us.
You look like sailors. You are welcome to stay with us.
They gave us food and drinks. All of us enjoyed the meal.
Come with me. We have made arrangements for you to stay.
He took us to a barn. You can stay here as long as you wish. My people will take care of you. All of us slept in the barn. There were two tribal guards outside the barn. They were watching us. The next morning, they gave us more food and drinks. All of us enjoyed the food. As we had eaten a lot, we felt sleepy, so we decided to sleep. We got up the next morning. Again, they gave us food and drinks. We ate a lot and slept. The same routine continued for many days. One day, after eating, I decided not to sleep and explore the island instead. I was walking through the dense trees. Suddenly, I heard somebody whispering. I decided to take a look. As I went near, I saw the tribal leader talking to one of his men.
Master, how many more days do we need to feed the sailors?
I think a couple of more days. Let them become fat and healthy. Then we can eat them.
I am sure they will be delicious.
I was shocked to hear this.
Oh my God, they are cannibals. They are going to eat us. I have to do something. I ran towards the barn and woke up my friends. I narrated the whole incident to them. Sinbad, what should we do? I have a plan. I decided to request one of the guard who was standing outside our barn. Sir, please help us. I have a family. All of us came here by mistake. We don't want to die. Please help us to escape. The guard had pity on us. He decided to help us. The next morning, he took all of us towards the shore. We made a platform using a few wooden planks and bamboos. We thanked the guard and set sail on the platform. It was a difficult journey, but we had to do it to save our lives. We sailed for many days. After a few days, we reached another island. The shore was guarded by the king's soldiers. They immediately caught us and took us to the king. I narrated the whole story to the king. Don't worry, you are safe here. But you will have to work hard if you want to survive on this island. Majesty, we are ready to do any kind of work that you assign us. The king ordered us to take care of his horses. We started living on that island. Every day, we used to feed the horses. We also had to clean the stables. I even took the horses for rides. The king was impressed by my hard work. He got me married to a nobleman's daughter. Months passed. One day, my wife died due to illness. I came to know that the kingdom has an unusual custom of burying the living spouse along with the dead one. I was shocked. The soldiers forcefully buried me along with my wife in a wide and deep pit. They gave me a jug of water and 7 pieces of bread. I was in a lot of pain. I thought, I am surely going to die here. As I moved around, I noticed a burrow. A fox was staring at me. I forcibly moved my legs and shouted. The fox ran and disappeared. I understood that this was the last chance to save my life. I slowly and painfully crawled through the tunnel and reached the shore. A goods carrying ship was about to leave the shore. I got into the ship and requested the captain to take me to Baghdad. After traveling for a few days, we reached Baghdad. I was happy to meet my family. So this was the story of my fourth voyage. It was a dangerous voyage, Master. Yes, it was. Please tell me about the next voyage. Sure. Sinbad started narrating the next voyage. I thought I would give up sailing after a near-death experience during my fourth voyage. But my love for the sea compelled me to make the same mistakes again. I bought a new ship and hired a new crew. I also appointed a new captain. We set a sail. It was a beautiful journey. We traveled for many days. We passed by many mountains. A few weeks into the journey, we decided to halt on an island. We went near the island and anchored our ship. All of us went on the island. As I started exploring, I realized that it was the same island which I had visited during my second voyage. The island with the giant bird, the rock. As my crew was hungry, they started preparing food. Hey, look, an egg. Wow, it will make a great meal. The sailors started throwing stones to break the egg. When they broke the egg,
a little chick came out of it. They roasted the chick on fire and made meal out of it. When I came back, I realized what they had done. "What have you done? The giant bird will not forgive us for this. We are in danger. We should leave this island immediately." All of us ran to the ship and we set a sail. A little time in the journey and we saw two giant birds flying over our ship. They threw giant rocks to attack our ship. The big rocks were falling on our ship one after the other. I knew we could not survive for long. Soon, our ship sank. I somehow managed to save my life. I started swimming and soon reached another island. I started exploring the island. There were beautiful trees, sweet smelling flowers, and low hanging fruits. I ate a few fruits as I was hungry. I slept the night. The next morning when I woke up, I saw an old man dressed in palm leaf skirt sitting right in front of me and staring at me. "Who are you?" "I am Sinbad, the sailor. I lost my way and reached this island. Can you help me pluck the fruits by carrying me on your shoulders?" I agreed. I put the old man on my shoulders. He caught me by wrapping his legs around my neck, almost strangling me. I took him from one tree to another. The old man was plucking the fruits. I was in a lot of pain. "You will have to carry me on your shoulders every day. If you don't listen to me, I will kill you." I had no choice but to obey him. Every day I carried the old man on my shoulders as he plucked the fruits. He was a cruel man. He punched, kicked, and choked me every time I asked him to get down. I decided to escape from the island and save my life. One day, as I was exploring the island, I came across gourd vegetables and grapes. I thought of a plan. I broke the gourd in half and cleared the insides of it to make a cup. I took a few grapes and crushed them. I fermented the liquid in the vegetable bowl and made wine. Days passed. I had to carry the old man on my shoulders every day. One day, I offered the old man some wine which I had made. He happily drank it. He looked surprised and happy. "Wow, what is this?" "It's a fruit juice. It is fantastic. Can I have some more?" "Yes, sure." Without any hesitation, I offered him more and more wine. He drank many cups of wine and finally passed out. This was my chance to escape. I ran towards the shore. I saw a ship passing by. But it was at a far distance from the shore. I started swimming and after a long time reached near the ship. The sailors helped me get onto the ship. I requested them to take me to Baghdad. We traveled for many days and finally reached Baghdad. I was happy to be back again with my family. So, what do you think about this voyage?
It was great, Master. Please tell me about your next voyage.
Sure. Sinbad started narrating the next voyage. I was living happily with my family. I bought a few camels. I started a business of transferring goods using these camels. I had all the wealth I wanted. But once again, my mind tricked me into going on another trip for the thrill and adventure. I said goodbye to my family and set sail along with a few friends and merchants.
we traveled for many days.
We went to a lot of ports and delivered goods. One day, as we were sailing across a few mountains, the ship's captain said, "I think we have lost our way. I don't know where we are." All of us were afraid. Suddenly, the ship crashed into a big sea rock. The ship broke into pieces and all of us fell in the sea. Some of my friends and a few merchants drowned. I was left with a few other people. We managed to swim and reach an island. As we started exploring the island, we saw diamonds, rubies, gems, and precious stones. All of us were happy. We collected as many stones as we could. After some time, all of us were tired and hungry. Sadly, the island had only a few herb plants for food. My friends and other merchants started fighting with each other for food. Eventually, all of them died. Some died of hunger and some died because of the fight. With a strong will to live, I decided to explore the island and save my life. I was carrying a heavy bag full of diamonds, rubies, gems, and precious stones on my back. I was getting tired. After walking for a long time, I came across a river. I collected a few tree branches and built a raft. I kept the bag full of stones on the raft and set off on the river. It was a difficult journey as the river had dangerous fishes and crocodiles. I came across many rocks on my way, but I decided to continue. After traveling for a long time, I saw a cave. I decided to be brave and travel through it. As I went inside, it was very dark. I thought the darkness is never going to end. But after some time, I saw light on the other side. When I came out of the darkness, I was surprised. I saw civilization. There were houses, boats, and even people. I reached the shore. I went near a group of people and spoke to them. "Hello, sir. I am Sinbad the sailor. I have lost my way. Where am I?" "This is Sri Lanka." "Don't worry. We will help you." They took me to their king Al Hind. I narrated my entire story to the king. The king was very happy. "You are a brave man. I will help you get back to Baghdad." He gave me a bag full of gold coins as a gift. He ordered his men to arrange for my journey. I said goodbye to the king and his men and set a sail. After traveling for many days, they dropped me off at Baghdad. I showed the stones and gold coins to my wife. She was very happy. Now, we are wealthier than before. So this was the story of my sixth voyage. It was a great voyage, Master. Please tell me more. Sinbad started narrating the next voyage. I continued living a happy life as a merchant. But it was not too long before I decided to go on another voyage. One day, I said to my wife, "I am going on another voyage along with a few merchants." "No, please don't go. We have enough wealth. Why do you want to risk your life?" "Don't worry, dear. I promise, this will be my last voyage." My wife was sad, but she let me go. I said goodbye to my family and left for my seventh voyage. We traveled for many days. I was enjoying my journey. We traveled past many islands and mountains. As we traveled further, we also passed by icebergs. One day, there was a fierce storm, thunder, lightning, strong winds, and heavy rain. The captain said, "I cannot see anything." All of us were scared. Somehow, we managed to pass through the storm. After the storms subsided, we thought we were saved. But the captain said, "We have reached the furthest corner of the world, called the Sea of the King. This is where Solomon lies buried, under the waves. I am sure that there is no way out for us. We will soon be killed by large fishes and sea monsters." As we looked around, we realized that we were surrounded by large fishes and sea monsters from all the sides. Three giant snakes were coming towards us. The captain increased the speed of our ship in order to escape from the monsters. Somehow, we escaped from the monsters. But eventually, our ship crashed on a reef. All of us fell in the sea. I managed to grab a plank and used it to stay afloat. After 2 days, I reached an island. I grabbed a few fruits to eat. I gathered a few tree barks and bamboos and made a small boat. I started sailing. After a few days, I reached near a valley. The force of the water was taking my boat very fast. I thought, "This is my end. I'm surely going to die." But as my boat was about to go down the waterfall, a fisherman's boat came across and saved me. The fisherman helped me sail my boat towards the shore. Once we reached the shore, I said, "Thank you very much for saving my life." "Don't worry, you are safe now." He took me to his town. It was a peaceful town. He took me to a wealthy merchant's house. The old merchant asked, "Who are you?" "I am Sinbad, the sailor. I have heard a lot about you and your voyages. You are a lucky man who has God's blessings at all times. You have escaped dangerous seas 7 times. I also know that you are a wealthy merchant." He asked me to marry his daughter. His daughter was very happy to marry the sailor of 7 seas. I got married and started staying in that town. During my stay, I encountered many dangers, such as an evil bird and a giant serpent. After my dangerous adventure in that town, I decided to return home. Me and my wife took a ship for Baghdad. I said to myself, "This is my last voyage. I will never travel the seas again." We traveled for many days to reach Baghdad. This was the story of my last voyage. So now that you heard about the dangers and the hardships I had to go through to become wealthy, do you still think it is unfair that I have these riches? I am sorry for my earlier statements, Master. You have gone through a lot to achieve everything. Please forgive me. Both of them hugged each other and decided to be good friends for life.
I'm sure you enjoyed watching this video. Please click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel and watch more interesting videos.